on NBC.
Back from the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum, halftime of the XFL's Million Dollar Championship Game. That's a live look inside of the San Francisco locker room.
Hey.
The Los Angeles locker room is about 30 minutes of football away from splitting $1 million. It's been all Los Angeles here for the million-dollar game so far in the first half. San Francisco's got the comeback in them. They came back last week in the playoffs down by 16 points. It's going to take a whole lot to come back down 21 against a very good L.A. team here. But here at halftime at the XFL's Million Dollar Championship game, we've got some fun stuff for you, including some looks back by the players at some of their own personal favorite moments in the XFL's inaugural season, and a cheerleader fest of sorts. There are roughly 80 girls here representing all the XFL teams, and there's going to be some big cheerleader spectacular coming up at halftime as well.
Yeah, great road trip for them.
As far as football here, first half highlights dominated by the L.A. Extreme. Indeed, from the opening snap, L.A. took over. A three and out after San Francisco. It was an early Jose Cortez field goal at from 42 that got him started. The play action by Tommy Maddox and a pass reception. The H-backs, seldom used, were a big part of the offense. This was a big play. The quick kick by San Francisco, picked up by Reggie Durden. The penalty didn't bring it back. He returned at 73 yards. L.A. was off to the races at that point.
Well, I think one thing that Jim Skipper seriously has to reconsider is Mike Pawlowski, a quarterback. Not that Michael has been bad, but they need some kind of lift down 18-zip, and I think Pat Barnes certainly proved last week that he could bring the team back.
You know, and a big difference certainly as well in the kicking game in this one so far. We've seen Jose Cortez in his range. This guy's outstanding. He had streaks of 8 and 9 consecutive field goals, and he's been money today.
Well, and especially when he gets lined up with the wind at his back, as we saw in the closing seconds, 50 yards, and he could have made that one from 55 or 60 because the leg was there with the wind.
You know, he's one of the great stories in the XFL this year. This is a guy that about 9 months ago was nailing shingles on roofs. He got a phone call on his cell phone from Al Luganville and said, want to kick field goals this year? And today he's kicking for $1 million.
I remember Tommy Maddox getting very upset with Al Luganville about bringing Jose Cortez in a game back in Vegas. But like you said earlier, Matt, in his telecast, since then, since about week 5, the man has been money.
There have been a lot of good stories, actually, throughout the year on this L.A. Extreme team, including Saladin McCullough, who we told you about earlier. Guys like Darnell McDonald and Jermaine Copeland, the most prolific receiving duo. And Tommy Maddox as well, who is back with a new football life. What adjustments need to be made as we look into the San Francisco locker room by the visiting team here tonight?
Well, I think they have to be able to run the ball a little bit more. Last week against Orlando, Kelvin Anderson was a factor. But Los Angeles has taken them out of a lot of the good things that they do. Go back to those short, intermediate stuff. Create situations where it's 2nd and 6, you know, 3rd and 3, and not getting caught in bad situations like they had been most of the first half, Matt.
Well, we told you that all the cheerleaders are here representing all the XFL teams. Let's join that performance in progress. Told you a moment ago we were going to revisit some of the players' favorite moments in this inaugural XFL season. Who better to walk us through this first year of XFL football than the guys in the trenches themselves? It is perhaps the most eagerly anticipated inauguration that the sports world has seen in quite a while.
My favorite moment actually was in the very first game when we were coming out of the locker room. Begin the game, just fireworks going crazy. It was an atmosphere that I'm glad that I was involved in.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the XFL!
I think having all the players mic'd and getting the sound back into the stadium,
Billy, good job, baby,
creates an atmosphere around the league of the guys are out there playing the game and they're playing it and having fun.
Let's go! Somebody talk to me!
It's over! Woo!
Have a good one.
Personalities showed out. Personalities showed up. When someone scored, they did their thing.
Oh yeah, I love showing off my character. That's the biggest part of it at the beginning. Now they just told me to be me. The best end zone dance I've seen in the XFL is probably with the big guy from Orlando who just scored and tried to spike the ball and he dropped it, then he dove on it, then he picked it up, threw it up against the wall.
Guys, yes! Really playing for the love of the game. I think that's one of the things that sticks out in my mind.
I look back and know that I helped get this league started.
I think I'd look back on it and think that the XFL was a blessing for guys like me. You know, guys who couldn't make it into the NFL. And a lot of guys fell in love with football again. They had no idea.
You've been out there on the field, you're sweaty, you're bloody, and you come off the field a winner. I can't even explain how it feels. You know, it gives me chills talking about it right now.
The XFL is the best thing that's happened to me, and it's the best thing that's happened to a lot of these players because it's given us a chance to play the game that we love to play. You couldn't ask for anything better.
Well, you heard Tommy Maddox himself. The XFL's been the best thing in the world for his career and a lot of players around him. Even better for those suited up with the LA Extreme at this point because they're off to a commanding 21-0 lead at halftime and route to a million-dollar payday at the end of the football game today. Moments ago, the coaches in the LA dressing room addressing the troops.
Talk with your pads! You got 30 more minutes, man. Play it all out.
Yep.
Leave it out there. Kicking game, we got the return offense. You go right on the field. Don't let up. 30 football minutes. And you're champion. Let's go.
And
if you got something to prove, man, you better fly around and get after their ass. And then good things will start happening for you.
Right.
All right? We're kicking it off, and we expect a turnover. Defense, go out there and stop them right now. And offense, we got to get uncorked. So let's go right out there and take it to them.
Probably tough to motivate down 21 zip at half, but this is it. If you can't motivate a team for a comeback to win a championship and $1 million to split nicely amongst yourselves, then there's no motivating. 21-0 Los Angeles. Halftime as we begin the second half of the $1 million championship game.
On the side of the field that you can plant on your good foot.
I'm good. Don't even worry about it.
Are you sure?
Yeah. I'm sure. I got all day to heal.
Okay.
Let's go.
All right. Hey, man, I just want to make sure. You know what I mean? Because you're still giving on it.
Yeah, I know. I know how to cut off this one. Trust me. I'll break it down.
Okay.
All right, back at halftime as we prepare for the second half kick. San Francisco really with their backs to the wall. Jermaine Copeland and company, that much trumpeted LA offensive attack, has been everything that we promised in the first half.
To make matters worse, Los Angeles gets the ball to start the second half.
And all of a sudden, as we've lost the sunlight here at halftime, guys, it's become windy and cold. You're looking at veteran cornerback Dwayne Harper at 35 years old after over 10 years in the NFL. the guy who decided to play in the XFL this year because he wanted to win a championship, not because he needed the extra blue, not because he was some guy that couldn't give up football. He wanted to win a championship and find out what it was like.
He got close, went to the Super Bowl, but didn't win it. The power of the ring, a powerful thing.
Damon Gibson got a huge block and takes it back across the 20. That's where L.A. takes over to start the second half. Miller genuine grab, second half, first half stats rather. Time of possession was San Francisco. Everywhere else, it was just about a clean sweep for L.A., including a big discrepancy in passing yards.
Let's go, Kingsbury, 48, Tommy, on one, right?
Tommy Maddox was 10 of 18 for 134 yards and a TD in the first half.
It's a big series for the Frisco defense right here. They got to set the tone.
Oh, Jesse, I got to correct you right there. If you live in San Francisco, you never say Frisco. It's the first time I've corrected you all year, and it was on something completely insignificant. We'll talk about that later. Well, we mentioned Dwayne. Don't look at me like that, man. Don't look at me like that. Dwayne Harper wanted to play this year to win a championship, as we told you earlier. That's what this is all about.
Don.
I was telling the guys earlier, I started playing football at the age of eight, and I've never won a championship, game. I think that would just, solidify my career. It would be the thing that I've always dreamed of, being on a championship team.
Going to come from behind if he's going to get it done tonight. Little handoff brought by Saladin McCullough. He blows through the first wave of defenders. There he is. Near high school in Pasadena representing. Knocked out by Wendell Davis, the date of 32.
And a late flag for hitting him out of bounds. They're going to probably tack on 15 more.
Y'all can't stop me.
And with all due respect to Chicago's John Avery, over the past 4 weeks of the season, this man, number 24, Saladin McCullough, has been the best back in the XFL. Coming into this game, 237 yards rushing into the previous two games.
And this is hardly the way Jim Stiffer envisioned starting the second half.
Here's the whack and the personal foul. There it is. It's that right hand to the helmet.
Wendell Davis, the culprit, and the sign of a team that gets a little desperate when they start committing fouls like that.
Money.
49.
Big gainer and a penalty tacked on. Pitch back to McCullough. He crosses the 30 after a gain of three. We talked about how Tommy Maddox was grateful for the XFL for an opportunity to get back into the football world. How about Saladin McCullough?
We talked to him the other day. Extremely humble after all the stuff that he has gone through with his personal life.
I heard that if he wins today, he's so happy and grateful he's going to give his check to Vince McMahon.
48!
On second and eight now. Maddox with time to set up shot. He finds Darnell McDonald. That's been a familiar theme. McDonald and Copeland on display again tonight.
Incidentally, that $1 million divided 45 ways comes out to about $22,222.22 per man. Does Vince need that?
Roughly.
Only a graduate of Northwestern could figure that out off the top of his head.
This is on Dwayne Harper.
For what?
Picking on the veteran.
Oh! 48.
A first and 10 now for Los Angeles.
48.
Inside the 20. Maddox litter towards the end zone. That one's picked off by Kobe Wright.
They're going to call him down, but it's still a pick. It's a big turnover for San Francisco.
The former Las Vegas Outlaw comes up with a big stop on defense for the Demons.
First poor throw that Tommy Maddox has thrown in about 4 weeks.
Nickel!
And even though it looked like he was eyeballing him all the way, he never saw Toby Wright, the safety.
So San Francisco takes over deep in enemy territory. They begin the drive at the two. Coach Lugie watching.
On a post.
We'll be right back.
So far excited. I'm on a go or a comeback.
How about raising that?
There's a secret society where the night is eternal. The music is essential and the party is non-stop. You could be the newest member. The MGD Music Jet Tour. Four parties, four cities. One unforgettable trip. Peel the label, enter the code at MGD.com, and prepare for takeoff.
Dear sir, thank you for changing my son's life. He has said that if he makes it through basic training, he'll never be afraid of anything. In my proudest moment, I will watch my son march across that field with his head held high. Thank you for bringing out the best in my child.
Graduation is just the beginning. Log on only at GoArmy.com.
Tom Green here at Muscle Beach with some big top weightlifters.
We're going to show how right guard extreme sport works even under the most extreme conditions.
Back, stop!
Uh-oh.
Run, go down the kitchen, he's going to get you! He got ya! Look, extreme protection against odor and wetness. Goes on clear and it doesn't quit.
Right guard extreme sport. Get extreme. Get right guard.
Ouch.
The Weekend Warrior. These men don't play for money. They don't play for glory. They play for the love of the game.
No, we don't. We do it for them.
Well, then, if you're trying to impress an XFL cheerleader, I suggest you huddle up with Stacker 2. Stacker 2 is the safe, smart way to burn fat and get an extra boost of energy. Stacker 2, the most valuable fat burner.
The Million Dollar Game on NBC is brought to you by cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft. Never miss a genuine opportunity. By the United States Army, an army of one. By Right Guard Extreme Sport. Get extreme. Get Right Guard. And by Stacker 2, the world's strongest fat burner.
Make it loud for your defense.
Tommy Maddox seated next to Scott Milanovic, the man on his right. Milanovic, incidentally, was the first ever draft pick in the history of the XFL. He happens to share time with Tommy Maddox, and Milo doesn't get much of it. Maddox, of course, as we talked about earlier, the league's MVP. That's Kelvin Anderson stopped by Matt Kennelly after no game.
Yeah. And as much as we've talked about the L.A. offense, let's give due credit to the L.A. defense, who has played exceptionally well in that first half.
10 consecutive quarters without giving up an offensive touchdown. Bolaski out of the shotgun from the back of the end zone. Get out of the way. Gets smoked as that one's incomplete. Matt Kennelly came and put him on his rear end.
A touch!
Just in case you wanted to know what it was like to be in number 9 shoes. Third and long. Again, on a shotgun from the end zone. Pulaski rolling in the corner of the end zone. Dumps it off incomplete. Nothing going on. Backed up from their own 2. And a big wind in Mike's face. And you start to wonder, yeah.
You got to pull him. I think you go to Barnes at this point after you give up the ball. You gave him one series here. He did nothing with it. You got to do something, Jim Skipper, to spark this offense.
And also to signal to your team that, hey, we're not giving up. Mike Panasek to punt from his own end zone. Oh, a little squibber. That's the last thing San Francisco needed. Reggie Durden picks it up. And L.A.'s going to take over in wonderful field
position
yet again.
We do have a penalty flag, though. We do have a flag. We got to see what the flag is.
kicking team, player number 54, illegally downfield on the kick, 5 yards from the end of the run.
Man.
First down.
Nothing going right for the Demons here tonight. LA on offense again. Regis not here, fortunately.
You are watching NBC, network of the NBA playoffs and NBA finals. America's Air Force has a plane so advanced, it dominates everything in the air. Yet on radar, it's as small as a bird. The meanest, baddest bird on the planet. Join the team that keeps us flying. America's Air Force. No one comes close.
Introducing new Twisted Crust Pizza from Pizza Hut. It's breadsticks, it's pizza, it's both. With your choice of free marinara or ranch dipping sauce. It's a totally twisted new way of eating pizza. The Twisted Crust Pizza from Pizza Hut. Another one of the best pizzas under one roof.
So how are we getting home?
Good question.
Hop on in, guys.
File this under never. When you need a ride, save big bucks and dial 1-800-CALLATT for collect calls.
You know how they get like that? They get like that by eating the meat.
Yeah. Whopper says carnivores prefer flame broiled.
In the land of burgers, the flame-broiled Whopper is king. The XFL.com Fan Picks, the Burger King Defensive Player of the Year. In the land of burgers, Whopper is king. Birmingham Bolts linebacker James Willis is the XFL.com Fan's Pick. Willis was an intimidating force on defense all season long and led the XFL in tackles. Needless to say, he was one of the biggest hitters in the league. That was the XFL.com Fan's Pick for Burger King Defensive Player of the Year. In the land of burgers, Whopper is king.
Well, Mike Pulaski threw for almost 300 yards in their first matchup, the Extreme and the Demons. Those are the numbers tonight.
Coach, maybe Mike has not been in the most advantageous of situations, but you're in desperation time here. When do you have to give this team a boost and possibly go to Pat?
Well, at some point in time, we got to make that decision. You know, we discussed it with the offensive coordinator and whatnot. So we're going to have to make a decision here, and we're going to let it go and see what's happening here. But, I mean, hey, you're backed up at the minus two. That ain't a good spot. You know, the guy's got to hurry things. And he knows he's in the end zone, so you can't hold it that extra time. So, you know, we'll make that decision somewhere. I mean, it's got to cross your mind. That's just football.
Saladin McCullough hand up the middle. Chops away for 6 more yards on what is already an impressive line.
It's great on short, you know, when we need to first down or get a completion, you know, get positive yards. But good. Yeah, you can't forget about screens, too. Screens looks good, you know?
Pat Barnes is the type of quarterback.
He's got to be the eternal optimist, saying anything looks good right now.
Well, when he's on the sidelines, he doesn't just hold the clipboard. This guy is more into a game as the backup quarterback than many quarterbacks that play as a starter. Maddox looking for the corner. Jermaine Copeland, touchdown, Extreme. A flag on the play. We'll see if it brings the touchdown back. If not, it's an even bigger San Francisco hold. Penalties on San Francisco, decline, touchdown counts. Jermaine Copeland with a 19-yarder. How much fun does Jermaine Copeland have on the field? Guy is just having the time of his life.
Dig that. Dig that. Dig that.
And it's just beginning.
Hell no.
Former Tennessee star. Getting a lot of limelight these days. They're lined up for a one-point conversion try. Pitch back to McCullough around the corner, and it's good. Everything going right for Los Angeles today.
Hey,
Tommy Maddox with the play fake, knowing it, Copeland all the way, who was working one-on-one with Dwayne Harper,
there
who had
Copeland
to commit pass interference just a bit on that little pitch route there.
Coming into Los Angeles, bringing the aerial attack too.
Refreshing as a mountain stream. Head for the mountains of Busch beer.
Never once did your car ask you for jewelry or flowers. Never once did it ask you if it looked fat, or did it get mad at you for leaving the seat up. Your car always gives you exactly what you want. Doesn't it deserve something special in return?
Something is coming. On May 4th,
go!
Prepare to live the adventure.
Oh my God.
The Mummy Returns. Rated PG-13 at theaters May 4th.
Point Gibbons' performance raises the bar. California's finest.
He's so big. He's like, a big locomotive.
Accelerates toward Churchill Downs. He's primed for Derby. The chase is on.
The Visa Triple Crown starts with a Kentucky Derby in 2 weeks on NBC.
Football, you bet. 28-0 Los Angeles style. Jose Cortez set to kick with 9:16 left here in the third. Brian Roberson and James Hundon back to receive for the Demons. This is James Hundon. Reverse. Jimmy the Jet looking for someplace to go. Ricky Parker there to make the tackle on special teams.
Jermaine, you're making a statement on the field, but before the game you made a statement as well, talking about Mike Pulaski starting at quarterback for San Francisco and how pleased you were with their decision to start Pulaski.
Well, I mean, Pat Barnes really took him past Orlando, and that's what we was kind of looking forward to, but they decided to let Pulaski do the start. Hey, that's what they do. That's their business. We got to worry about ourselves.
So now you've backed off a little bit.
I ain't worried about it myself. You know, I'm just worried about what's going on with me. I'm trying to do this thing right out here in L.A., trust me.
You know what? I think he's looking for a movie deal is what he's doing. Continues to be a rough day for Mike Pulaski.
I tell you, when he gets under duress, the mechanics get shaky. He throws off the back foot. Happens to every quarterback. You got to wonder when Jim Skipper's
gun
is going to make that decision.
Ready?
I think he'll...
Yeah.
I think he'll make the switch if he doesn't do anything here. He's got to.
And then it may be too late.
All right, 90.
Pulaski was hoping to make this game the capper on what has been a big week in his life.
What on earth was that? I think that was supposed to be a shuffle pass,
yeah.
That never developed because the receiver never got out front of him. You're in trouble as a quarterback if you roll out like that and you're ahead of your receiver, right, Mike?
Absolutely.
Dave Ritchie down after making the tackle.
At least he didn't pitch it.
We're talking about Pulaski, guys, and the fact that he was trying to make this, or hoping that this would be the final day of a great week for him. His wife, Tracy, gave birth to the couple's first son. Young Casey was born during the week. And Mike was hoping to be able to show Casey tape of this game and saying, see, this was the week you were born, son.
You might say, never play football. Never play football, yeah, Casey. Yeah.
Not only that, but poor little Casey's going to have to get his college tuition somewhere else because it doesn't look like he's going to put none in the bank today.
We talked to Mike Pulaski yesterday, and regardless of what happens here in the million-dollar game, he'll think about next season as a player. He'll go back into the announce booth for Cal Berkeley football and take it one day at a time.
No! Fight 19! Fight 19!
Hut! Hut! Third and 11. That's been the story all night long.
Intercepted.
Picked off. Ron Carpenter, he had a pick in week 10 versus San Francisco. Another for him, a bunch of big hits on the field. He fumbles the football.
They're going to call that a forward lateral, I bet.
What the Dave Casper is going on out there?
What?
Pulaski going back here, firing over the middle. And again, throwing into double, almost triple coverage.
And then getting nailed trying to make the tackle. I tell you what, Michael is one tough guy.
No doubt. No doubt.
And he deserves all the credit in the world for getting San Francisco to this championship game, but he is having a tough time.
It was two, wasn't it? He said he'd been lurked. Yeah, it's two man. I thought he was just going to beat the back and come across his face. Huh? Yeah, me too. Thought he was going to beat him right now.
Now, Pulaski plays with a lot of heart. Regardless of what's on the scoreboard, the guy goes 110%. Good penetration in the backfield, but Saladin McCullough still on his feet.
He went from a 7-yard loss to a 7-yard gain with sheer effort.
That was a short call.
I think that was the lady from Weakest Link on the other line.
You are our quarterback, too. Got it? Bang, bang, change, don't worry about it. We can see if we can get a spark from top. It's everybody. It ain't just you here. Got it? Hear me?
Yep.
I love you.
Saladin McCullough up the middle. Ripping away more yardage.
Coach Jim Skipper saying kind of what we were saying up here. Mike, you've had a great year. You're still our quarterback, but we got to go for a change.
You know, that was a nice exchange there as well. Some mutual admiration. This is how that conversation
Everybody,
ended.
It ain't just you here. Got it? Hear me? I love you too, baby. You hear me? You hear what I'm saying?
That's why they like playing for Jim Skipper.
You bet. And that's why everybody respects Mike Pulaski.
48!
First and 10 once again for Maddox in the extreme. He's hit as he throws, but it's still complete. There's the big smooth again. Darnell McDonald, a gain of 16. Another L.A. first down.
Mike, we heard, obviously, Coach, they're going to go with Pat right now. I said to you a second ago. Tough position for you to be in, but do you think it's the right move?
Well, you know, we're not getting it done on offense if Pat can give us a spark. When I say give him a spark, he's a hell of a quarterback. He helped us. He won the last one. Let's see if he can get us out of this.
Is there any one moment you thought to yourself, well, you know what, this is not going the way we need to. We need to make a change.
No, I never give up, never give in. I still haven't. 48! 48!
McCullough looking to dance behind his line. Gets back to the line of scrimmage.
He has been fun to watch the last couple of weeks.
That play's no good.
You know, Mike, this is exactly what L.A. needs right now. When you got a tough back like McCullough, you give him the ball, you let him run the football, it keeps the clock running, and you start getting closer to that payoff.
Absolutely. Not a bad average of the afternoon, huh?
You know, last week, prior to the playoff game with Chicago, Loterio Rochelle, who was one of the receivers here with the extreme, said he had a dream that Saladin McCullough was going to rush for 124 yards. This was the day before the game. McCullough ends up rushing for 164. But, I mean, they should look to...
You know what that tells you, Matt? Never believe what you dream.
I want to talk to Lotario Rochelle after the game. There he is, and ask him,
about
some
the
other
stock
stuff.
Market.
Take
yeah.
it down to Vegas. Make myself a little sugar. Lotario, who's going to win the NBA Finals? And don't listen to what Jesse 48. Says about the Timberwolves.
That's called Ching, Matt.
48!
On 3rd and 10, Maddox back to pass. Dumps it off to Frank Leatherwood, who scored a touchdown tonight.
And a late flag coming
in. Oh,
and
a little extracurricular on the field, too. They got a little brawl going on with Eric England, the big defensive end. That's Chris Brimmer of Los Angeles.
Let's go. Separate. Let's go. Go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get out of here.
What up, Chris? He is hacked off.
Got to sort this one out and see what they come up with.
Personal foul on Terry Russell, number 99 on the defense. Half the distance to the penalty. First down.
They call it on Eric England.
It's all, Ho. Come on, baby. You got him. Twice, Ho! Twice.
A lot of frustration out there, Mike, and that's what's showing up right now.
They have not been able to get to Tommy Maddox all afternoon long. That front four for the San Francisco Demons, which we underscored at the top of this telecast, they were the key. Put some pressure, get some heat in Tommy's face, and they've been unable to do it.
How about that? I'm sitting here selling people now, and that's not going on.
How about that, huh?
Maddox, the peacemaker.
Now, they gave Tommy 15 yards for just saying something, and they didn't throw nothing there for the extracurricular stuff.
A
little bit of bias there.
Come here. Come here. Hey, come here. Come here. Come here. Hey, come here. Come here. Come here. I got him. Hey, come here. Listen to me. Listen to me. The officials have said they're watching them tight. Don't do anything stupid. Anything that they do, we're going that way.
Hey, man, I can get him on the goal.
Y bunch 42
on one, right?
Tommy Maddox's center, Jonathan Heimbach, says Tommy doesn't talk too much, and when he does, we all listen to him.
All right, baby.
How can he say that? He's talking every game we've done.
Not to his teammates, though.
Delayed draw to Saladin McCullough. Inside the five. Wendell Davis among those on the tackle for San Francisco.
Let's go bunch. Rocket Florida special. I'm on right. Press it. This way. Darnell! Darnell!
What is it, Tommy?
Rocket Florida special.
How good has this man been?
Go! 48!
And he's running like the game is still tied.
And yeah, they're in McCullough territory here inside the five. Pass is complete to Darnell McDonald.
No, that's a good call by the official because the ball never got in the end zone. His leg might have been in there, but the ball never crossed the plane.
Do that again, man.
Trying to work on Wendell Davis again on that corner.
I tell you, D-Mac got away with one there. He pushed Wendell off and came back for the football. Created the separation himself with his arm. And you can see the discrepancy in size and why it's been a huge matchup problem for San Francisco.
McCullough dropped for a loss. That was Greg Williams that penetrated the backfield. Finally, San Francisco's able to stop him inside of scoring territory in the red zone there. Here comes a field goal unit for Los Angeles. And that money former roofer from Mexico, a guy who's kicked barefoot for much of the season, got the shoes on tonight, Jose Cortez. He's been good from 34, 37, and 50. His longest this season tonight.
I can't imagine him missing this one.
That's what they call a chip shot. Football, you bet. 31-0 Los Angeles. A lot of pressure on Pat Barnes to try and come back late. We'll be right back.
You having fun at your party, honey?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I gotta tell you something. These last few years have been great.
Oh, they sure have.
But now that you're six, we're gonna have to trade you in.
What if you treated your kids?
No hard feelings, right?
The way you treat your car.
Let's have some cake.
All right.
Don't trade your car in when the warranty's expired. Come to Pep Boys for expert service and now free Gabriel Pro Rider shock installation.
Happy birthday!
All you need to know is where to go. Pep Boys.
Yeah, I'm the ultimate competitor. Go G-O-A-T, etc. Light years ahead of ya. They chose me instead of ya. Corny cats, you better. Give praise to the greatest. Yeah. Silence all challengers. LL ambidextrous, switch the left hand on ya. Leave it on the floor, pure, raw stamina.
The Weekend Warrior. These men don't play for money. They don't play for glory. They play for the love of the game.
No, we don't. We do it for them.
Well, then, if you're trying to impress an XFL cheerleader, I suggest you huddle up with Stacker 2. Stacker 2 is the safe, smart way to burn fat and get an extra boost of energy. Stacker 2, the most valuable fat burner.
It's all-new NBC Superstar Thursday, and it starts with Winona Ryder on an all-new Friends in the scene that's called The Kiss.
Fun!
Then we've got Woody for Grace on an all-new Will and Grace. Plus, Kathy Lee Giffords on an all-new Just Shoot Me, and Sally Field returns to an all-new ER.
Excellent!
All-new NBC Superstar Thursday.
A familiar sight from the 1984, and for some older viewers, the 1932 Olympics. The Olympic flame is lit here at the LA Memorial Coliseum. They only light that bad boy on very special occasions.
Well, the older guys better turn the sound up if they were here for the 32 Olympics.
Jose Cortez will kick things off with his extreme on top. 31-0. James Hundon and Jimmy Cunningham back to receive.
Bouncer.
And LA has a chance to recover that as it hit one of the up men for San Francisco. LA ball. God.
And Barnes still won't get a chance. Can you believe that?
And I'm not sure at this juncture in the game, Pat wants the chance.
Letario Rochelle, the soothsayer, the Nostradamus of the extreme, the guy that recovered.
Mike, do you use the standard ploy here after a big turnover? Do you go deep with the first player? You know, isn't that what normally you do? You try to strike quick.
Well, let's hope that Al Luganville has a little more respect for Jim Skipper than that. I'm sure he does.
There's the replay right off the old knee. Hard to tell who comes up with it, but we know it's an extreme player that gets it because they got the ball.
Sean Stuckey is the injured Los Angeles extreme player down after that special teams play.
Hey, Pat Barnes may not get his chance for quarterback, but
CYA.
Yeah, why not put Scott Milanovic in?
I would at this point. I'd make the switch right now.
When you come back from sideline. You got rid of it all year. Keep doing it.
Tomorrow on NBC, we've got another NBA playoffs triple header. First up, Vince Carter and the Raptors look to avenge last year's playoff loss to Latrell Sprewell and the Knicks. Then out west, the Suns take on division rival Sacramento. And in the nightcap, the Blazers and Lakers do battle in a rematch of last year's Western Conference Finals. It's an NBA playoff triple header tomorrow, 12 noon Eastern on NBC.
He has to report every
time. A timeout of the field. We'll be right back.
the night.
Well, lucky you came along. Most people wouldn't stop out here at night.
And they prey upon the living.
She's infected. What do you mean, an infected how?
They will possess you.
You kill the source of the origin, and you kill the strain.
The Forsaken.
Open the trunk.
Rated R. Opens everywhere Friday.
Hey, it's time to clean up your act with new Edge Clean Shave Gel. Edge Clean's got a built-in facial cleanser. It helps lift dirt and oil from your face to the phone, cleaning while you shave. So clean up your act with new Edge Clean Shave Gel.
I left my project at home.
It is 80% of your final grade.
Excuse me. I think a friend deserves an A. You got that?
This could happen. Emphasis on could. When you're in a jam, save big bucks and dial 1-800-CALLATT for collect calls.
Hi, Tom Baudet. When did you see the light?
Going over to Phoenix. We wanted to rest up for the game, and suddenly it was so clear. Motel 6. I think it's great.
Well, you got to call them like you see them. Call us and see the light for yourself.
Sports drinks. Not cutting it, okay?
What do you bench?
350.
Gallons?
By the way, your body called. Yeah, looking for some vitamin D and A. Come on!
Hey, I'm out of quarter.
Can I get a spot here?
Yeah. What are you drinking?
Sports drink.
Sports drink? Later, sunshine.
Well, you just hit the stop button. They got a stop button. Or you just stop walking, or you got to...
Want to play? Milk has 9 essential nutrients active bodies need.
I'm all right. I'm up.
That's Los Angeles linebacker Sean Stuckey, the injured player on that last play. A couple of casualties tonight for L.A., including their outstanding linebacker Jeff Russell, who was taken off the field in the first quarter.
First carry for Rashawn Sheehy.
Rashawn Sheehy, the former Washington Husky, among their all-time leading rushers. Another Pac-10 man there, Mike Pawlowski. A rough night for the Polish rifle.
Better days as a Cal quarterback here at the Coliseum. In fact, that loss in Week 10, the first time he's ever suffered defeat here in L.A.
48!
Leterio Rochelle, the guy in high motion. Maddox still out there slinging. And that one's incomplete. Jermaine Copeland just laughing and smiling his way closer to a $1 million payday. Dwayne Harper with coverage for San Francisco.
And I'll come down a little.
So many of these guys on this field here, Matt, have not won championships at any level, high school, Pop Warner, college, and for a guy like Jermaine Copeland, he did taste a little championship with the Tennessee Volunteers. This is one sweet feeling, especially when the hay is in the barn.
Back there,
we can run it out.
Which championship do you think he'll get more money for, the Tennessee one or today?
Oh, boy, what do you mean by that?
Hey, we're entertaining, guys.
Time expires on the third quarter. 15 minutes of football left.
Facts of Life by Lysol. Fact, with kids, you need all the strength you can get. Fact, Lysol All-Purpose Cleaner is the best because its strength kills germs even in water. The disinfection of fine salt is all washed up. Life demands Lysol. That's a fact.
You've got a lot to show for all your hard work. It's time to reward yourself. We've got just what you need. Long-lasting Chevy trucks. Now lease a 2001 Blazer LS four-door, four-wheel drive for as low as $299 a month with $1,934 due at signing. Residency restrictions apply. Call for lease details. That's $299 a month on Blazer. So get out there and make your money count at your Chevy dealer today.
Looks like you got a little nick there.
What, this?
It's nothing. Maybe we should get it looked at.
Or maybe we should go get a delicious Mike's Hard Lemonade instead.
You're on.
A hard day calls for a hard lemonade. Make it Mike's.
Facts of Life by Lysol. Fact, with kids, you need all the strength you can get. Fact, Lysol All-Purpose Cleaner is the best because its strength kills germs even in water. The disinfection of fine salt is all washed up. Life demands Lysol. That's a fact.
Good evening, I'm John Alston. Tonight on NBC 10 News at 11, a local minister is shot to death while riding in a church van. Now police are trying to find his killer. Also, riot police use tear gas and water cannons to calm thousands of protesters in Canada. Plus, a busy day in sports. Derek Castillo has all the highlights and a complete wrap-up of the NFL draft. And we'll have your exclusive Earthwatch forecast tonight on NBC 10 News at 11.
NBC 10 and MSNBC, get connected. This is the XFL on NBC.
Gold LeMay and I think Ann Margaret from Bye Bye Birdie. Either that or the suit that Elvis wore on the cover of 50,000 Elvis fans can't be wrong. All right, little too non-sequitur. Third and eight. Tommy Maddox still out there going long down the middle. He's got a man with single coverage. Incomplete, looking for Darnell McDonald.
And there could have been a flag on that. I think that was a gift from the referees right there.
Oh, Tommy, can you hear me?
Now, how did they not throw a flag on that baby?
Yeah, that looked like steer wrestling in the National Finals rodeo.
Darnell's got a little bit of a complaint there.
That's the first three and out by Los Angeles all night.
You know, five out of LA's eight drives have actually started in San Francisco territory tonight.
Just about any way you slice it, it's been all extreme.
Oh,
Jimmy Cunningham.
Let it go.
Watches it bounce.
Punches into the end zone for a touchdown.
Hey, rip!
Monday night on NBC, it's Weakest Link, the new game that's taken America by storm. Don't miss an all-new Weakest Link. Monday at 8, 7 Central on NBC. Watched it the other night. She ran away. My fourth grade mathematics teacher
that
scared
woman.
The heck out of me. She's half Angela Lansbury, half Attila the Hun. All she's missing is the writing cap.
And I guarantee you she's not an XFL cheerleader.
Well, Pat Barnes has been inserted into the offensive mix now by Jim Skipper just to try and put something up on the board here and start a comeback attempt late in the ballgame. Little screen pass to Calvin Anderson. A first down for San Francisco.
Well, that's getting a little something started. The difference between Mike Pulaski and Pat Barnes. He's a little more mobility in the part of Pat.
Well, and I think he's probably got a little better throwing arm due to the injury, too, Mike.
Sally Gunner.
Pulaski with the bad shoulder, and Barnes doesn't have that also.
He was 16 of 26 in the win versus Orlando last week. That one was thrown incomplete.
You know, Barnes, I'm sure, wants to be the good shoulder soldier and try to lead them to at least a couple of touchdowns for respectability's sake. But deep down inside, I don't think there's any reason why he wants to be in this game.
That last pass looked like he was throwing at the mascot, like in Varsity Blues.
Or back to Pawlowski, just as, hey, Mike, you get back in.
Go! 319! 319!
Fumble. That was Calvin Anderson. That was like the Ghost of the Post, Statue of Liberty, flea flicker, double, triple, reverse, secret probation play.
64, double right. 64.
One of the problems Barnes had last week was trying to run an option play. I don't think that's on him as much as it is Calvin Anderson.
Well, that play never was doomed from the beginning with the penetration that the Los Angeles Express had on that play.
All right, there it is right there. That was the first. I'll give you a mulligan on that, okay? I thought I was going to be the guy to call the Express this season.
Oh, I did. God,
yeah,
that's right.
You dropped an Express.
Steve Young, Don Klosterman, where are you? Oops.
Put the blue lane. I'm on the camera. They got me on the camera. No, listen.
a chapstick moment.
Big smooth mugging for the camera a little bit. Mike Panasek on to punt. It's a live ball at the 47. But Panasek's really had a tough day kicking the ball today. And a quick tackle made on Damon Gibson after receiving the punt. All L.A. at the Coliseum tonight. We'll be right back.
Dear sir, thank you for changing my son's life. He has said that if he makes it through basic training, he'll never be afraid of anything. In my proudest moment, I will watch my son march across that field with his head held high. Thank you for bringing out the best in my child.
Graduation is just the beginning. Log on only at GoArmy.com.
She's a real beauty. And she never bugs you about spending so much time with the guys. She never complains about you watching football. She thinks a little gas is a good thing. Maybe she isn't a she after all. Here's to the perfect relationship. Here's how to keep it that way.
To play real football, my kind of football, raw survival in the mud and snow. No domes, no fair catches, no phony grass. It's harsh, it's bruising, so it's beautiful. Think you're tough enough to play my kind of football? Then come and get it.
Introducing the official game ball of the XFL from Spalding, the toughest football ever.
Come on, Johnny. Oh, Johnny's mom is calling up.
The time is now for the Knicks and Latrell Sprewell. A run to the finals has been a season-long goal. But the Raptors and Vince Carter have the firepower to derail New York. Raptors-Knicks starts a playoff tripleheader. The place is here. The NBA playoffs on NBC, Sunday at noon Eastern.
Can't beat it, baby.
The Million Dollar Game on NBC is brought to you by The Forsaken, a new film from Screen Gems, opens everywhere April 27th. By New Edge Clean Shaving Gel, it helps lift dirt and oil every time you shave. By 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls. And by milk, with 9 essential nutrients. Got milk?
Back at the Los Angeles Coliseum, 31-0 Extreme in the XFL's Million Dollar Game.
48!
It has been all L.A. Tommy Maddox, the league's MVP, still out there directing the offense, and Saladin McCullough continues to run roughshod over the Demon defense. First down on a pickup of 20. McCullough now over 100 yards of offense and perhaps en route to MVP hunters tonight, guys.
It's either him, Tommy Maddox, or that offensive line of the Los Angeles Extreme.
Well, you know they ain't going to give it to the old line.
Well, we can change things, though. Why don't we start a trend?
No, you.
I really thought that way back when this might be the vehicle for which offensive linemen would finally receive their due. And McCullough dropped for a loss this time.
Well, Pat, they didn't show Mike a whole lot of love when he was in there. How tough is LA's defense? I mean, obviously, they want this thing badly. Can you make it respectable?
You know, you got to give them credit. They played well, but a lot of things have not gone well for us offensively, defensively, special teams. It's tough breaks, but that's why we play the game, and hopefully we can end it on a good note here and roll into next year.
Abdul Salam Noah, the youngest of the Demons, just a 22-year-old defensive tackle, was the man down after that last play.
Was that a concession speech on the part of Pat Barnes?
Sounded awfully close. Some would call it a realist speech.
Yeah.
Make this money.
What's up, Antonia? What's up?
Get this money. Ain't nothing funny. Take this money.
Thank goodness they're football players.
You know, for a lot of the guys on the LA Extreme, the extra $26,000 is going to mean the difference in being able to make a house payment or a home improvement. We had a chance to talk to some of them about what they were going to do with that extra money. Jose Cortez, the kicker, who's been so outstanding this season and tonight.
Let me guess, he's going to put a new roof on his house.
Nope. That's what he does for a living. He's going on a honeymoon in Jamaica with his fiancée after they get married. That'd be a nice pop for him, huh?
Yeah. Clifton Abraham, the cornerback for Los Angeles. Give his mom a brand new fence at her home in Dallas, Texas.
The one that most alarmed me was when Jerry Krabs, the veteran left tackle, claimed that he was going to take about $10,000 and give himself liposuction and breast implants.
Have you seen those things jiggle?
That's it's a frightening thought, but who am I to tell Jerry Krabs how to spend his money?
Well, coming from where I come from, a few of them better set aside some for taxes, too.
48! Second and 11 now. A little misdirection that time as the pass is incomplete. Good to see Abdul Salam Noah okay to leave the field under his own power. For Mike Panasek, perhaps back to Lebanon, Indiana to continue his career as a drama teacher.
I'll bet you the L.A. team's hoping that President Bush's tax cut comes through.
I'd say he was the toast of the town in San Francisco week one when his 33-yard field goal beat these same Los Angeles extreme teams.
On the blitz, they dump it off to Saladin McCullough, who dances out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Everything going right for L.A.
Well, Tommy Reed's defense as well, and there was a classic example. He saw that big rush coming. They had the right play called. He just drew him right in, suckered him in, and flipped it out to McCullough.
And willing to take the hit, Jesse, just create that situation.
These are two of the brightest stars in the XFL. That's Aubrey Battle, who is down receiving attention to a cramp. And when I talk about the two stars, Maddox, McCullough, two huge stars that the XFL has given a forum to this year. They've taken full advantage.
That's what I was setting up.
It's finally looking like Al Luganville looks relaxed.
Scotty!
Maybe not.
You know, his son Tommy, who's the quarterback coach here, said that his greatness isn't his coaching ability. He said every coach in this league can coach. It's selecting players, player personnel.
And Tommy Maddox.
Congratulations.
Done for the night.
The XFL's MVP, and with good reason.
Good job.
44. So Scott Milanovic now under center, and his first pass is incomplete. Milo, as we mentioned.
Good job, Bo. Great job today, Bo.
Good job.
Hold on, I gotta sleep.
Hey, Matt, did you notice Luganville put on a rain jacket?
That's a veteran move right there. That is a veteran move, and it's not because it's raining.
44! Coming!
44! Speaking of Scott Milanovic, again, he was the XFL's first ever draft pick. Didn't get a whole lot of playing time this year because Tommy Maddox, who would go on to MVP hunters, was awfully hard to sit down.
Well, that's what I was saying earlier about Al Luganville. His ability to identify talent, his strongest suit, picking not one but two good quarterbacks. Milanovic surely would have been a starter with many of the teams in this league, in addition to the same extreme team. Finding gems like, you know, Copeland and Darnell McDonald were late picks in the XFL draft.
Jermaine Copeland, by the way, would have been a regional pick by the Memphis Maniacs. Who was choosing on that one?
Yeah, they picked four other receivers beside him, and Al Luganville, knowing talent, said, hey, baby, this guy can play for me anytime.
He and Darnell McDonald, the most prolific receivers duo in the XFL.
Great job, Bob. Great year, baby. Yeah. Great playing with you.
Hey, yeah.
Good job, Saint. You all right, Bubba? Great playing with you, all right?
Hey, you too, baby.
Great year. Hey, that's a great run. No messy.
Well, here's Jose Cortez now to try for his fifth field goal of the night and attempting to break his own XFL record. He hit four at Las Vegas.
Oh, bad snap.
It won't happen here. Noel Prefontaine is scrambling.
Intercepted.
Throws and it's picked off.
What do you think, Mike? Could that be the thing that turns it around?
Big John DeWitt came up with the pick. It's not going to erase the smile off Tommy Maddox's face.
Yeah, Jesse, it's a 15-possession game.
Yeah, huh?
Now, they get like that? They get like that by eating the meat.
Whopper says carnivores prefer flame broiled. In the land of burgers, the flame broiled Whopper is king.
It takes a lot to keep our aircraft flying. Nearly 750,000 remarkable individuals. Our people are the fuel we run on. Join us. America's Air Force. No one comes close.
I know, you practically live here. The odometer even says so.
Well, maybe it's time for a little homeowner's insurance. Unless you prefer spending time with used car salesmen. Look, the solution's clear. New Quaker State higher mileage engine for engines with 75,000 miles or more. It's specially formulated to help prevent leaks, oil consumption, and loss of compression. So if you don't want to stop at 75,000 miles, then don't. New Quaker State higher mileage engine. What more do you need to know?
When the question comes, and it will, have I got what it takes today? Answer with this. Gatorade Energy Bar. Carbs to build stores of energy. Energy to burn. What burns inside you?
Next week, the Saturday Movie is back with Blockbuster Movies. Adam Sandler as Happy Gilmore, the network premiere of Sphere, Steven Seagal in Under Siege 2, and it all starts next Saturday with GoldenEye at 8, 7 Central.
No more foreplay.
GoldenEye, next week on the return of the NBC Saturday Night Movie.
31-0 Los Angeles here in the fourth quarter. The XFL's million-dollar game, then a runaway for Los Angeles. Saladin McCullough already signing autographs.
Green 88!
The equivalent of the fat lady has sung.
Pat Barnes passing off to Calvin Anderson. He bobbles, and it's picked off by Leamon Evans.
Well, you know, everything went wrong for San Francisco, but I will say this for him. If I had to vote of who had the best fans in the XFL, I would give it to San Francisco. And let's give credit to the Demons. You know, they overcame some tough games late this season to make it into the playoffs. They went into Orlando. They beat the favorite team of the XFL, really, with the best record. So Jim Skipper can walk off and hold his head high for a very successful season, even though they lost this last one.
You bet. Although, Jesse, I'm sure in Jim's wildest dreams, he never thought there'd be a recurrence of what happened in Week 10, and this is actually worse. 49. Shut out 24-0 here 2 weeks ago with Sean Sheehy for a couple yards. Well, Jim Skipper, like the rest of the coaches in the XFL, as he told us yesterday, he's going to take a little time off.
And remember, Matt, San Francisco still got all three timeouts.
That's an important factor here, down 31-0 with just over 7.5 minutes left. That's
plus,
Scott Adams.
Plus the two-minute warning.
Scott Adams, a guy we talked about earlier in the telecast, and a guy who played tonight in memory of his father. He's still wearing a bracelet on his wrist made from his father's work boot. He's used that to motivate him in whatever walk of life he chooses.
His dad, a real blue-collar guy who lost his battle with emphysema and cancer about 6 years ago, and toughest man that Scott's ever met in his life. Every time things get tough like this, he looks at that bootlace.
And he'll realize, looking at that, that there's more to life than a football game.
Absolutely. Clock at 6:40 and ticking.
49.
Milo hands off to Sheehy, back to the original line of scrimmage.
League MVP Tommy Maddox, this game firmly in hand, 31-0. What are your feelings and your emotions on capturing the first XFL title?
Well, you have a lot of feelings and emotions. You start every season hoping you have a shot at winning the championship, and to be able to play with these guys on this field at home in front of these fans and win it all, it was a great deal.
What is next for you, Tommy?
Right now, this is next for me. I don't care what's next. This is what we wanted to do, and I'm going to celebrate this one for a long time.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Stick around. We'll be right back.
You having fun at your party, honey?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I got to tell you, son, these last few years have been great.
Oh, they sure have.
But now that you're six, we're going to have to trade you in.
What if you treated your kids?
No hard feelings, right?
The way you treat your car.
Let's have some cake.
All right.
Don't trade your car in when the warranty's expired. Come to Pep Boys for expert service and now free Gabriel Pro Rider shock installation.
Happy
All you need to know is where to go. Pep Boys.
Attention, tobacco manufacturers! You have a lot of embarrassing reports lying around the office. You can't just leave that job to any paper shredder. You need Shredder 2000!
That is right, folks. You need the Shredder 2000 to use on documents like this research report from 1981 that says today's teenager is tomorrow's potential regular customer.
Or this report where you actually draw the smoking patterns of sixth graders.
And you know what, folks? With the Shredder 2000, you don't even need to take those highly confidential files out of the cabinet. You can just throw the whole darn thing in. Files you got on your computer, just throw the whole computer and it's gone.
Completely gone. You need Shredder 2000.
Shredder 2000, now available in regular and king size.
The Weekend Warrior. These men don't play for money. They don't play for glory. They play for the love of the game.
No, we don't. We do it for them.
Well, then, if you're trying to impress an XFL cheerleader, I suggest you huddle up with Stacker 2. Stacker 2 is the safe, smart way to burn fat and get an extra boost of energy. Stacker 2, the most valuable fat burner.
Demon cheerleaders still dancing, smiling, and raising the roof and carrying on, having a good old time. In fact, all XFL cheerleaders are here for this million-dollar finale. One that has been thoroughly dominated 45. By the LA Extreme. Scott Milanovic in at QB, finds Jermaine Copeland the same way Tommy Maddox did all night. Inside the 10, a pickup of 24. Now, not even Jermaine Copeland could think of more superlatives for this one tonight.
Here we go. Trip stop 45. I want to watch it.
Well, they open up a can of whoop butt and never look back. And you can only do so much trash talk. And after a while, you realize that, just a better team.
But that's enough. Even Rod Strickland shuts his mouth every once in a while. That's where Sean Sheehy stopped at the line of scrimmage. You know, Jermaine Copeland told us, before this thing ever started, prior to the opener, that he was looking forward to coming out to L.A., hanging out with his buddy Will Smith, and getting himself some love in the media. He wants a TV show. He wants a movie deal. He wants a recording contract and a website.
He sounds like Judge Smales' kid heading to the hot dog stand.
He also said it's way too crowded out here. He doesn't like the freeways, and get me back to Tennessee. So will the real Jermaine Copeland please stand up?
You'll get nothing. We like him.
Rashawn Sheehy. Missed.
Oh, they got him.
Got an innocent bystander and a ball boy.
An assistant.
There's somebody else coming.
That's poor execution of the Gatorade.
But you know what?
And that's
Come
the
on.
Only thing they've done poorly tonight.
Al puts on a coat, not because it's cold, but because he knows he's going to get a bath. Take it like a man.
Make good TV for us, darn it.
77, yeah. Go.
Yeah, and pretend you're surprised. And go,
44.
Yeah. Give us a little love.
44.
Third and goal for Milanovic. Now hanging it into the corner. Jermaine Copeland can't stretch out for it. Let's break down just where this went wrong, Mike, Jesse.
Well, what you've got to do first is get someone to distract the coach. You've got to get someone in the coach's face before you do that, man.
Look at this classy movie. Uses the kid as a defense mechanism.
the human shield. Like Saddam Hussein, the human shield.
You know, they'd be better off next time get two of the big linemen to pick Al up and stick him in.
Or like they did when they clinched the Western Conference title, use Fred Rogan.
Right, absolutely.
44, hot!
Here's Rashawn Sheehy. He's going to throw it. And it's caught by Lekario Rashawn. This is what you call kicking a corpse.
When's next year's LA-San Francisco game in San Francisco?
Oh, there are going to be some marked men next time these two teams play each other. That's a lot to do when you're up by 31 inside of 5 minutes.
Now I can see giving Milanovic some time to throw the ball because he might well be the quarterback next year for the Los Angeles Extreme, but that, I don't know.
Yeah, there's John Hansen who tried to just break that thing up and say, I know you're home, I know you're winning, but come on, fellas.
Hey, Matt, I just figured it out why they did it. The over-under was 36.
Oh, my goodness. And that was Carl Hansen, by the way, that broke that up. This is Sheehy, and this is a PAT.
Sean Sheehy with the point conversion.
Al, you're up 31-0. And you pull a play like that. Was that pointed out?
Well, they called timeout. We were running the clock out. They called timeout. We're going to go and get as many points as we can now.
Al, before you go, nice movement on the Gatorade bucket. Now, you put on the jacket to protect yourself,
and then
you ran away.
It was cold.
Oh, that one?
Yeah.
Well, we thought you put it on because you knew it was coming. Well, not again.
There you go.
I remember 2 weeks ago. Okay.
Well, they almost had it timed out to get Rogan in there, too.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations to Coach Luganville.
Hey, the hell with him. That's right.
Oh, his son, Tommy.
I feel great for our staff,
our players, all our families, everybody that's been involved in this. I just feel super.
It's been quite an odyssey putting this team together, winning in its initial season.
No question. I just don't know what to say. I'm lost for words right now, and I just feel really good.
You know, that's odd because, Al, as long as I've known you, you're never at a loss for words.
I am now.
A thorough trumping by the Los Angeles Extreme. They are en route to finishing the season, by the way, guys, with three consecutive shutouts.
Enforcers put 16 on the board last week.
Who's got the shirt?
But no offensive touchdowns did they give up.
James Hundon starting the kickoff return from his goal line and tackled at the 22. Well, for Tommy Maddox, the XFL has probably been the best thing to happen to his career since he signed up to enroll at UCLA. Some 9 years ago. And for a lot of other players, they can say the same thing. We've talked at great length tonight about guys like Rashawn Sheehy, who have resurrected their careers courtesy of the XFL. this league has given a lot of players a chance to play in front of a national audience, a chance to once again enjoy that team dynamic, a chance to make a little money doing something they like. Pat Barnes running for his life. People like John Avery in Chicago, Kevin McDougal. You know, here's what I think about this whole thing as well. This league's greatest asset remains the fact that the players are paid for performance. And it's really tough not to get behind that kind of dynamic as a fan in this day and age of escalating player salaries.
I'll tell you what else I liked about it, too. I didn't go to one game this year where the fans in the stands did not have fun. They had a good time at every XFL game.
Yeah, the in-stadium experience has been one of the best things about this league.
Not to mention, Ebonics is back in the national lexicon as He Hate Me is now being worn on high school jerseys all over America.
Rod Smart asked to give commencement speeches.
In all honesty, though, the football in this league from week 1 to this week 12 is a completely different story. And it's a shame that a lot of people, a lot of opinion shapers over the course of these United States really didn't give it a chance after week 1. You try telling a guy who's down 38-0 here with just seconds left that this doesn't matter.
And Pat Barnes in the unenviable position to come in when the team is down by so much. You know that they're going to throw the ball. You know that the opposing team is going to tee off.
Oh, wow. Got sandwiched there by his
own man, Scotty Adams.
His own man is right tackle. And Pat's down.
Yeah, I'm all right. Let's go. Yeah, cool.
Well, there's been a lot said and a lot written on the future of the XFL. We do know that this championship season for the LA Extreme has been solid from beginning to end. And these football players and these coaches, the football operation here really has a lot to be proud of.
I think the big turning point for LA was that second game with Chicago that went to triple overtime where they were in trouble. They really should have lost that game, and they found a way to win it. They would have started 0-2 otherwise, I think.
You know, when you put together a football team, continuity is a very important thing. Al Luganville had handpicked his coaches. They had all coached with him before. He knew exactly what direction he wanted this team to go, what kind of offense they would run, and that was a big head start for this team.
As a lot of players told us yesterday, it's about winning a championship. Yeah, everybody gets a $25,000 pop on the winning roster, but a championship's a valuable thing and something that these guys take a lot of pride in.
Oh, man.
Jermaine, throughout the year, perhaps you've had more fun than anybody and expressed it. How do you feel tonight?
Oh, I feel great. You know, I mean, hey, I told them they better have their heads on straight or something bad's going to happen. It's 38-0. We had a hell of a game. Offense, defense, that's LA Extreme at its best. Okay. Baby!
Jermaine, before you go.
This is Odoman Sampson at quarterback.
What about your future in films?
You never know. I hope it works out. If it does, you know I'm going to, but if not, oh well. Football's my life, baby.
It's tough not to like that guy. Again, Odoman Sampson has replaced Pat Barnes at quarterback for the San Francisco Demons here as they wind down the clock inside of 2 minutes.
The 25-second clock is not operating.
And once again, we should remind everyone that San Francisco has all three timeouts remaining.
Special. Out here.
Just a minute and a half left of football in this inaugural XFL season. Odoman Sampson trying to make something out of nothing. Create some kind of positive with which to end the season. He does lunge up for a first down.
Yeah! Sampson, baby!
I wanted it to be good. I didn't think it'd be this good.
to basically have the full final 15 minutes of a game, knowing that you have the game won, to celebrate. I'm surprised nobody's brought out their own, you know, home movie camera.
Hey, I want to take time out too to say, Mike, thank you, Matt. It's been terrific. We've had a great time and a lot of fun.
Vice versa, Jesse.
Sampson out to Jimmy Cunningham.
And the best thing for me was learning all those big words that Adam Lee taught me throughout the broadcast.
Tommy Maddox celebrating with friends and family. It's a guy who had just flat given up football, went and bought a couple of insurance companies in Dallas. He was playing a lot of golf, decided to give it another whirl, and this is a guy whose career is alive and well today, thank you.
Did not need the money by any stretch of the imagination. Just the love of the game. I love you, Daddy.
25.
One of the reasons Tommy Maddox decided to play here, and we heard this from other players as well, is that their kids had never seen them play. And it's a powerful thing when 3-, 4-, 5-year-old kids get to see dad out there strapping it on playing professional football. And it's really been a dream come true for Tommy Maddox.
And how neat for the kids to be on the sideline.
Been a raucous crowd at times here in Los Angeles.
You know what else it is too, Matt? His kids will get a new pair of shoes now.
That's a little more than that, I hope. Baby needs a new pair of shoes.
And or front teeth, yeah.
Of front teeth. I was just going to say that.
Casey, they're going to interview you, okay?
Remember Mr. Rogan that interviewed you?
So, are you proud of your dad tonight?
Yes.
How proud are you?
Very proud.
What did he do tonight? He won the championship.
Uh-huh.
And you might get a new toy out of it. So it's a good night for everybody.
Yes.
Okay, sir.
You know, Fred's usually brilliant at extracting information out of women, but I think there's a certain age they need to reach.
He met his match.
Right, absolutely.
Hey, buddy.
Thank you.
Proud of you.
Thank you.
Nice, buddy.
That is baby.
Oh,
that is baby.
Oh, look. Oh,
God. That's J.K. McKay, a former standout wide receiver and local football legend from USC, who is the general manager here in Los Angeles. Congratulations to J.K. as well. He has worked his tail off to bring professional football back to Los Angeles.
Not just professional football, but a championship.
Done a great job. Odom and Sampson on the run as we're inside of 30 seconds, and there's a touchdown for San Francisco. 21-yard rush for Odom and Sampson. Makes a new friend in the back of the end zone.
Well, now, of course, they got to make that decision on an onside kick.
And remember, they have three timeouts, remember?
No, they're down to two. They used one.
When?
They used one.
We missed it?
They're going to go for the three-point conversion.
Left.
It'll be a try from the 10-yard line after the touchdown.
3 points from the left hash mark.
And why not?
And you feel for that man as an assistant coaches that spend so many hours, 12, 14 hours a day, breaking down film and trying to concoct a game plan that works. And to have it end like this.
From the 10, a three-point conversion drive. Odom and Sampson keeps it, looking for a receiver still. And still moving. What the Fran Tarkenton is happening out there? It's kicked off. Tinker Keck, Tinker Taylor, Soldier Maker, and he's finally taken down.
Hey,
A reminder, fans, tomorrow at noon Eastern, tune in for another NBA playoffs triple header. First up, the Raptors visit the Knicks. Then it's Phoenix and Sacramento out west. And in the late game, the Blazers battle the Lakers.
Great job, buddy.
Tonight, following your late local news, Saturday Night Live with that loose cannon whack job Tom Green and musical guest David Gray.
Love you, buddy. Come on, girl.
Like many an NFL Super Bowl, this one ends in a blowout. Congratulations to the LA Extreme for not only today's championship victory, but for a great inaugural season in the XFL. The Extreme able to do tonight what a lot of professional football in this city had been unable to do for years. Rams, Raiders, Mark Wilson, Vince Ferragamo, yikes. The Extreme, in their first season in the league, have enjoyed a phenomenal success story in 2001.
Hey, what up, boo? What up, big guy? I told y'all we were going to play one home for Tina, baby. Oh, yeah.
I told you, Mike, they're going for the onside kick.
Saladin McCullough.
I don't know what for.
Ron Carpenter fields the onside kick. Oh, and he's got a corner.
How about a little Cal Stanford here? Look at this.
Look out for the trombone player in the corner of the end zone, and they take Carpenter down at the 9. 14 seconds left.
They try to blow me up for no damn reason.
That's why I ain't go out there.
LA's gonna line up to take the knee. Top to bottom, point to point, whistle to whistle domination by the LA Extreme. Well, guys, as we're doing our little feel-good goodbyes, I'd like to thank you guys for a great season. Jesse, Mike, and on behalf of Fred Rogan and Chris Raggy and the rest of our crew, it has been a lot of fun this year.
It's been a great time. It's funny how these seasons start and you think they will last a long time and they just fly by. Before you know it, you're in the playoffs and in the championship.
You know, and the neat thing about it for us is we enjoy sort of the same kind of camaraderie that the teams do on the field. We've all spent about 14 weeks together, counting the preseason and stuff. And how about a salute to our Jackie Singer?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A salute to what?
Our delay switch girl. I thought she was our MVP.
Congratulations to Coach Al Luganville and the 2001 XFL champion, Los Angeles Extreme. The inaugural season of the XFL is in the books, and it has crowned a fantastic champion in the Los Angeles Extreme. The preseason favorites come through with a big win at the end, a 38-6 trumping over the San Francisco Demons. And these guys from L.A. tonight will be divvying up $1 million. On behalf of Fred Rogan, Chris Raggy, Jesse Ventura, and Mike Adamley, this is Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for tuning us in.
Number one.